Hey, what's up guys, this is Creative Creator here. Sorry for the late uploads because I was busy with my work. I've also captured so much clips for you guys, but to be honest, I don't get any much time for editing up those clips, so I don't have made those videos easily. So I have to get time for editing up those clips and make a video. So in this video, I will show you how you can convert your old PSU or old SMPS computer SMPS to a lab bench power supply, which you can use in your daily day of work. So with that being said, leave a like, subscribe to this channel, and let's jump into the video. So for this made, I'm just using my 450 watt SMPS and I am connecting my IEC cable to it, and then I will give the mains power to it. Then you can see the power is not coming and it is the fan of the SMPS is not running. So what we have to do is we have to connect the green wire of the 24 pin jack to the black wire, any black wire of the 24 pin jack. So what you're gonna do is we just short those pins, a green wire and the black wire. So it is the main switching wire. So when we switch those wire with a copper wire or anything like a wire, you can use other things, any metal wires. Okay, so when you connect those things, then you can see that the SMPS fan will run. So it means that the SMPS is on. If you connect this and your SMPS fan is not running, it means that your SMPS is not working or SMPS is damaged. So it is the main reason that SMPS got damaged or not, because I have upgraded my SMPS, so this is running. I know that it is running. So I have opened that wire, and then you can see when I connect the green wire and the black wire, then you can see the fan is running. So it means that the SMPS is all right. For measuring the voltage, I have set my multimeter to DC 20 volts and then connected the black probe to the negative of the wire, or it means the ground of the wire, and then I will connect to the yellow wire. Then you can see it will show the 12 volt. So in the meter you can see 11.46 or 44, it means nearly 12 volt, then it is all okay. If I connect it to the red wire, it means the 5 volt. So here you can see the voltage is 4.83, so it is okay. And then you can see if I connect to the orange wire, which is in the 24 pin connector, so it will give 3.3 volt. Then you can see when I connect it to there, it is giving 3.47, so it is okay and we can use it in our work. Here is a Bronix SMPS. So here you can see the most amperes is giving on the 3.3 volt rail and the 5 volt rail. So it is the old model of the SMPS, and if you get the newer SMPS, then you can see the 12 volt rail gave the much current. So you can see that the which SMPS is for you. As it is the old SMPS, so it is okay then. So now you have to open the fan connector. You can see here the fan is connected here. Firstly open the fan from here, and then you can see the wires are there, so much wire. So firstly what you have to do is we have to just cut out the wires. So firstly what I am doing is I have to open the wire from the socket. So I am just opening it here, like there. So here I have to connect all the wires from here. So I will take a cutter and then cut all the wires from the SMPS, and then you can see there are many colors wires. So for your better experience, I have made a chart for you guys, for if you understand more easily. So here is ATX power supply mains. When power supply comes, 110 volts to 230 volts, and then you can see the various voltages is there, and you can use those voltages for your work. So here are 12 volt, 5 volt, 3.3 volt, ground, and minus 12 volts. And then you can use this for your daily day work, but minus 12 volt is not too much ampere, so I am omitting minus 12 volts. And here is the power supply colors, which you have to know that the what voltage it will provide. So black means the ground, where the yellow means the plus 12 volts, and red means the plus 5 volts, orange means plus 3.3 volts, blue means minus 12 volts. And here I have mentioned that The minus 12 volts is low amps, such as 1 amps, 2 amps. So I will omitting it. So I will use only yellow wire, which will give 12 volt at 12 or 14 amps. So, and the purple wire, which is 5 volt standby when your SMPS is off, then also it will provide the 5 volt, and also the brown wire, which will give 3.3 volt sense. So we have to connect the orange wire to the sensor, which is brown wire. So it means that when the voltage is dropped to 3.3 volt to 3.2 volt, then it will automatically increase the voltage. So it is the main thing. And the green wire is for the powering up. So you have to connect any green wire to any black wire, which is ground, for powering up the SMPS. And gray wire, and you don't have to know for this. And if you have an old PSU from older than me, then you have a track for minus 5 volt. So you can also use that track for your work. So I am omitting that because my SMPS had no minus 5 volt power. So I will use only black, yellow, red and orange, and also brown. If you want to use brown, then you have to connect the brown and the orange for better 3.3 volt. So, and also I am using the battery connectors for the power, for the connecting of the wire. So you can use that for I am using for this. And also for the indicator, I am using a LED with a couple with 1k resistor, which I will connect to series with the 12 volt LED. It means that I will there is a ATX power supply, then I will connect to the plus 12 volts to a resistance of 1k, and then I will connect to the other, to the LED, and then to the ground. It is the connection, and you can obviously do this. So it is a connection for the LED. And I have said, for owning the PSU, we have to just need a green wire to the ground wire. Here you can see those four battery connectors I have just connected in the box, and I have separated in the same distance for better use. And also here you can see it is the, for the black one, it is a black wire, which is the negative ground. Yeah, it means what you say. And then you can see here is the GND is written. It means that it is the ground. And then you can see here is the it is a red wire. It is the orange wire, which is the 3.3 volt for your coming. And it is the red, it is a red wire, which is obviously the 5 volts. Here you can see it is a red wire. We have to it is a red wire. And here you can see in on the board it is written the 5 volt, and for the corner one it is a 12 volt rail. So here you can see it is the yellow wire. So yellow wire coming is there, and here you can see it is written plus 12 volt. So it means that it is the 12 volt rail. And also I have added a switch. So switch, you can see it is a green wire coming to it, and another a black wire. So I have firstly shown that for owning the SMPS, we have to just short the green wire and the black wire. So here is the light with the parallel of the black rail. So here you can see one LED is one terminal is yellow wire, which is the 12 volt, and another terminal of the black wire, you can obviously know that I have connected with the switch is ground. So here you can see it is the 12 volt rail connected. After that, the negative, it means that the ground, it is connected to the switch's negative, which is the black wire, I think. So it is the circuit, and anyone can do this. So after that, if when you click the switch, then PSU will on, and the light will be on, and you can work as well. So after that, I have added a ammeter and voltmeter with couple, and then you can see when I connect to 3.3, 5 and 12 volt, what, how much amps does it takes. So here you can see when I connect to 5 volt, then it is taking 3.5, 12 to the 5 over 5. So it is the main thing, and you can get maximum efficiency from this PSU, which you cannot get from the transformer. So guys, that's pretty much enough for this video. I hope you have a great day. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Peace.